Hi, my name is Matthew Sullivan. I'm a fifth grade teacher, a track four at the fabulous school of Carpenter Elementary, Cary, North Carolina. So I'm here today to talk about how wonderful my students are in fifth grade and how we have converted to being mostly digital learners. So our tools are using the Discovery Tech Book.
What Discovery Education is about learning about subjects that we learn in classes. We also use board builders to build boards and to show our teacher how much we understand about the topic, which right now is force and motion. And we also use a tech book to study for assignments and quizzes that we have like almost every week.
So I taught the social studies piece, which was this. So they created the research with me. And then the collaboration was with our tech teacher, Ms. Jones. Ms. Jones is a rock star. And then she taught them how to craft, to scratch. So it's kind of twofold. Research done in-house, this is sort of like a summary, in a digital summary, and instead of printing it, they just share it with me and I grade it. So it's basically a large unit summary. They have to put audio pieces and text, and then in technology, during the week at Carpenter Elementary, they learned how to scratch.
This is Scratch, and on Scratch we make a cartoon about something that we're learning in class. And so, for example, we were learning about the westward expansion in social studies. So we made a cartoon of a character who's basically traveling on the Oregon Trail. And so these little code thingies they help us make the cartoon come to life.
Okay, so these code things, they make like the wagon move. Like this one, it says move 10 steps. So it's making the characters and objects move.
We are building science songs. Our science songs are based upon all the standards, and I got this wonderful idea from Flocabulary, and our students create live action science songs on all of our science units.
I won't be getting cold. There are many, many biomes in the world, but they have different temperatures, I won't lie. Don't even get me started about the desert. There is never ever a cloudy sky.
I spy with my little eye many ecosystems I can take by flight. Many ecosystems I just walk by. Oh, I ain't wanna die in the desert cause it's way too dry. There is hardly any water to survive, yet some animals manage to thrive.
I spy with my little eye many ecosystems that are way too cold. At least that was what I was told. And there's hardly any sun to stay warm. Oh, I spy with my little eye. I spy with my little eye.
How many ecosystems are there in the world?
I think that there's 21 if you know what I mean. And the animal train going all the way. Got my lines on my back like my last name. And they're just like me because they can't be tamed.
I spy with my little eye. I spy with my little eye. Many ecosystems we just learned about. Many ecosystems we all know now. Oh, I spy with my little eye. I spy with my little eye. Ecosystems.
Okay, so the goal with the science songs was to make learning and understanding and focusing and vocabulary in science much easier and much more fun. So we were trying to make like very catchy beats, a very interesting like background, some very good choreography. And we're also trying to like make it easy to remember too. So like if you're in a test, you could remember what you were supposed to do. Like if you don't understand something about a certain ecosystem, you could refer back to the song to understand something about the ecosystem. It just makes like learning science a lot more fun, catchy, and easier. Anvia?
So what we had to do, we had to decide a song that we wanted to do, and so it had to be a song that all our group members decided on. And then we had to listen to the song over and over again to get the beat and to get the lyrics.
So like we did the science song because it's like fun and like it's a fun way to learn, and also we wanted to learn the vocabulary so we will be ready for the EOG.
Our students here at Carpenter Elementary will be ready for the bring your own devices in middle schools. They're going to be so skilled and trained that they can actually support the teachers, and that's our job as educators. The digital world is here. The question is, are you digital?